Yeah, I'm the W music producer. You are watching me on Miss Africa. Let it go. The name, I got the name from my big bro Cyril. Shout out to Cyril. You know, he was the first artist that I actually worked with, you know. So back then, he was working on his mixtape, Multiples of C, and I was fortunate enough to produce some songs on there. That was actually my first production for any major project, you know. So we had already finished recording the project and then we were just putting stuff together. And at that point, I didn't have a name to anything I was doing. So he came into the studio someday and then he just put a sheet of paper and just wrote down the name on the sheet, like, fam, I think there's a cool name that you can move with. So I was like, cool. I mean, at that point, it didn't have a meaning, blah, blah, blah. So honestly, I liked it. You get me? So I just took it and then we started with that project. And then from there, everything started moving. And then people got used to the name. And now that's what I'm moving with. I started making beats. So the journey hasn't been that long, you know, because started making beats around as a hobby in 2012. Around 2012, if my memory serves me right, you know, around 2012, and Cyril was actually the first artist that I worked with, you know. So I actually got my first studio experience from him, from his place, Mixdown Studios. You hear me? So it was from there that I got to meet different artists like EL, J Town, Edem, you know, just kept moving from there. Got to meet Feluna, who introduced me to Richie and got me signed as well. So after Richie, started working more, like doing more stuff on my own. You get me? Started networking with artists on my own, doing stuff, linking up with producers and all that, you know. So it was from there that, and I started dropping a lot of material for myself, you know. Released my first single, Chocomilo, with Wonder Boy. And then from there, it's been magic. I mean, the whole journey, it's been good. It's not been long, but it's been fire. You get me? More fire to the camp, so expect it. I wouldn't like to pinpoint one particular genre and say that, okay, yeah, I like to make this kind of music, I like to make that kind of music, because me as a producer, I like to be known as a producer that makes any kind of genre of music. You get me? So it could be hip hop, it could be Afrobeat, it could be gospel, it could be anything, it could be jazz, anything. You get me? Yeah, but initially I had serious hip-hop influence, you know, because I was moving with Cyril back then. And I mean personally, I really like hip-hop too, so, but I wouldn't say that that's my favorite genre or my main genre. But I mean, I make any kind. I don't know if you ever listen to my songs, you can tell I release any kind of song, from hip-hop, afro beats and all that. You get me? So that's how it is. I'd prefer to be the one man band man kind of producer. You get me? Play any kind of thing, any kind of music, and just move on. The inspiration is there, plenty of inspiration is there. Like, let me see. Yeah, so most of the producers I work with, all of them pure inspiration, you know, from Magnum, P. Wizzle, More Sound, Pac, Young Dems, Jules. I mean, plenty, Richie Manson, Link, Kill Beats. You know, more MOG, B2 of Dope Nation, you know, Wicked. That's like in Ghana. From outside Ghana, I would say Dr. Dre, Scott Storch, SARS from Nigeria, Mastercraft, Legendary Beats, you know. Yeah, different there. Next range there, like I said, the playing thing, because I like to pick influence or inspiration from, I mean, like, a lot of places. You get me? I wouldn't like to pick from one person. So you can say that I'm a blend of, like, different kind of producers. I feel like it works best for me that way. You get me? So I don't really stick to some kind of guy. I say, oh, I've been listening to this guy. Because, I mean, at the end of the day, if I'm not liking what you are giving me, if your stuff is not influencing me enough, then I'll just have to pick from somebody else. But, I mean, basically, just different kind of influences that I have. Yeah, I did pick up a Magnum. Shout out to Magnum. And it was the first single we actually recorded off the Songs for EP that I released with him in May. You hear me? So Magnum is a very good friend of mine, you know, so I usually go to his place to work and, you know, hang and all that. So I think I'd gone there like any other day and then dropped off some beats and just leave. So I was at home after one of those days, and then he hit me up, but like, bro, check your WhatsApp, I sent you something. And then I checked my WhatsApp and it was pick up. You know, by that point, it wasn't a fully done song. Again, it was just something that he had done to it. So I liked it, I really liked it. So I was like, bro, let's finish this. So it was after that that we even made up our mind to work on a joint project and release that. So after that, we did 3 more singles. We had Deliverance, Here We Go Again. And then, some other song, maybe like I forget it. Cause I work plenty, you know. But yeah, that was it. That was how Pick Up came up. You can get it on Apple Music, Spotify, Miss Africa, Aftown, Boomplay. Just put yourself on that. First off, big shout out to Flo Kingston, my big brother. And then the features Flo Kingston and then Gidochi, amazing singer as well. So initially I sent the beat to Gidochi. I made a beat and sent it to Gidochi to get a chorus and a verse for it, you know. So he hit me up that he had finished doing something and he wanted me to listen to it. So he sent it to me and I liked it. And at that time too, around the same time too, Flo Kingston was in town, you get me? So he came to my studio, and then he came to my studio to record some stuff for his album, The Gifted 2 album. Yeah, so you can go get The Gifted 2 album by Flo Kingston. It's not that old, so you can still get it on all streaming platforms and jam too. I produced a song on that album too. I produced My Way featuring Dr. Seed and Crayon, so you can check it out. Yeah, so that's how. So he came to the studio and then he came to record what he wanted to do on the project on his album, as in The Gifted 2 album. And then after that, he did the verse for me. Like, he just wrote and did everything the same day. And then from there, got a song mix, got a artwork, blah, blah, blah. And then you have the Dede right now. It's still banging though, so you can still get the Dede featuring Flo Kingston and Gidochi on my Apple Music, Spotify, everywhere. Just Google them, you will get them. Boy, big up Papi K. Big up everybody I ever work with. Big up Papi K, big up Kwame Dame, big up Slim Drums. You know, so I'd always wanted to, you know, back then, around the same time I was working with Cereal, I produced a song with Papi K on it, 5000, shout out to lyrics as well. So, I mean, from there we had, you know, there's a bit of some vibe between me and, bit of a vibe between me and Papi K, you get me? So I DM'd him some time that, yo bro, I like us to still work. You know, I was like, okay, fam, so come to the studio this day, and then I got in the studio and then we recorded. And even that day, I'm leaking more info for this interview inside. Even that day, when I got there, we recorded a song first, you know, with him and Akan. A song that I produced for his album. I think it's going to be on his album. If everything goes well, it's going to be on the album. So we recorded that song with him that day, and then after he did the verse for me on Young Boy. He heard it, I was like, yo, cuz. I was just playing stuff, Afrobeats, hip hop, every other thing. I was like, yo, fam, I like this one. Let me drop a verse, and then we did the verse, and then fast forward, you have a banger. Now until you go figure them on CRBT, you can use that as CRBT on Pired by Tunes My Muse. So feel free, just jump to the song. Let's move. What next for myself? I'm currently working on my debut EP. It's supposed to be out, if everything goes well, January next year should be out. Yeah, and I'm releasing the first single of the project in like 2 weeks time. Maybe that'll probably be in November. You know, that single features Spacely and then Danny Draco. Yeah, we recorded that song not long ago, like a couple of days back, and that's the first single. It's a very dope song. I actually can't wait to release it for you guys to actually hear it, you know. So yeah, I'm releasing that song soon. And then from there, I have 2 songs done already. That's the one with Spacely and Danny Draco, and then I have another one to Wicked Black and then Copter. Shout out to Copter. Yeah, so I have that one done. I have 2 songs done as well, so I just finish up and then you get a project. But you're getting the first single in some weeks time, so prepare, be ready. Yeah, man. You can reach me on my socials. I wish I could drop a number, but I can't. So you can reach me on my socials. You get me on Instagram, it's PLAYDREDW, play the W. That's the same for Twitter. And then Facebook is just DREDW, like DREDW. And then every other place, Snapchat, everywhere, just you will find me, just link up. Moku vibe, Moku work. Oh yeah. Yeah, fam. So you can get my songs, Dedede, Young Boy, and then Pick Up. You can use them as your callback ringtone on MTN, Powered by Tunes by Muse, all songs produced by myself. Link up, use them, vibe, download, stream, party, do whatever you want to do to the songs. Let's go. Yeah, so you can use my three songs as CRBT, Powered by Tunes by Muse. Let's go.